All right, everybody, we are back. We finished with the hood, and now we're going to do the body. Now, in this particular case, okay, this car is sort of going to be satin. It's going to be a satin finish. I want it to look just like this. So I'm only going to spray the clear. I'm going to go ahead and spray it all over the vehicle, after I'm done applying the decals, I will hit it with some dull coat, okay, and it'll bring it back to its original shape, but with the decals already between the layers of clear and then the and the dull coat, and it's just going to return to its original flat self, which is what I, you know, what I'm after here, okay. And it'll keep, you know, some of it is glossy and some of it is flat. I mean, that's part of the trick to this finish. So anyway, I'm gonna spray some more future on here, and you have to keep checking your cup because it does go. I mean, you do end up using it. So in this case, I'm gonna put about half an ounce in the cup, and go with that. And you also want to cover your liquid right away because you don't want particles to fall in there. Notice I'm not wearing my gloves just because we're dealing with clear here, and this one is just gonna go really light because I'm not gonna vomit. You know, just always apply your clear, your future, not your clear, your future clear, in smooth, even strokes. Don't vomit. Okay, don't try to build the gloss right away. If I actually wanted this to be glossy, it would probably take about 3-4 coats of what you're seeing me do, which is very light coverage. Okay, so anyway, I'm gonna crank this sucker up. This time I'm gonna run the extractor, which means I'll probably have to scream a little bit. As I said, I have it at 15 PSI. And then I'm dialing I'm trying to get a little bit. No. All right, here we go. Oh, wait, that's what I like about this airbrush. You can dial the how much liquid is going to go on here. So here we go. And, you know, as I said last time, six to eight. Inches away, and just keep turning the model. You want full coverage, but you don't want to bomb it. As I said, you don't want to bomb the surface of the model with clear, okay? And in this case, I'm going in all sorts of directions. Also underneath, the places where the decals are going to go are going to receive a little bit more, just because, again, it has to be smooth and shiny. You can see the shine picking up already. So just keep the model moving, turning it in all sorts of directions. You know, the future also protects. If you're gonna do washes or anything like that, if this were a tank, you'd have, you know, it's gonna protect your progress, where you've worked hard at getting the paint just right. See it going on, taking on the shine. And as I said, you just go slow. You go moving, making sure that it doesn't goop up on you or spit or anything like that. This airbrush is perfect for this job, folks. And you can slow down your stroke if you want the shine to get on there a little bit better. You know, you almost see it falling. And you want to overlap your strokes a little bit, just like they do in the real, with the real vehicles. Once you start turning it at an angle, you see the shine going on. All right, that's it for right now. And let me turn this off. And let me turn this off as well. So that's it for now. You know, you just let it sit for a minute. And then come with your hair dryer and dry it. It should be ready for decal applications. And as I said, if I wanted this to be shiny, a shiny finish, then, you know, I dry it, make sure there are no imperfections, then apply another coat, make sure there are no imperfections, apply another coat until it's achieved a very smooth, shiny finish. So, but this is good enough for my decals to go on just right without silvering. So, anyway, if you have any questions, let me know what you think, and we'll answer them. So thank you for watching, my friends. We'll be back with more Cranky Show. All right, next time you see this, we'll probably have some decals on it. All right, bye-bye.